In this video, we will walk through the setup and configuration screens of the GPS7500 receiver on the InCommand display. It is important to know where the GPS settings are located to verify that you are achieving the highest accuracy on your operation. By default, the display will automatically configure the port settings, but if connected to an older display, other ports may need to be changed. To access the GPS7500 setup menu, tap the Setup app on the home screen. Tap the receiver and steering wheel icon to open the GPS and guidance setup screen. Tap the wrench next to the receiver to enter the receiver setup page. On the General tab, we are able to change the differential source. Tap the drop-down to see the available sources. Only the differential sources that the receiver is unlocked for will be shown here. Glide and Wasson Egnos don't require a subscription or unlock. TerraStar L requires a subscription but does not need an unlock. The age of differential is the time limit of how long the receiver can go without receiving an updated correction signal before the differential source is considered lost. Each differential source has its own default value and should not be changed. When WAS is the selected differential source, Stable Locked is checked. This Stable Lock feature is covered in a separate tutorial if you'd like to learn more. Tapping the Reset to Default button will restore all receiver settings to factory default and remove all custom settings. The NEMA Talker checkbox is used to enable or disable the GLONASS prefix in NEMA messages. Older displays in some modules, like the water management modules, don't like receiving the GLONASS prefix. Even when this is unchecked, the receiver is still using GLONASS in the correction, but is just not sending the information to the display. To change the output baud rate, GPS position rate, or Hertz rate, in which NEMA messages are being broadcasted, tap the Port A tab. The port that has Connected next to it indicates that the display is connected to that port. The InCommand display will automatically configure the port for the settings it needs and will not let you change the output baud rate or disable the GGA NEMA message. Tap the Port B tab. Since the display is connected to Port A, we are able to edit all settings except the GGA NEMA message on Port B. These settings would only need to be changed if Port B is connected to another display. You will now be able to locate the GPS settings page and know where to change the differential source and edit the port settings of the GPS7500 receiver. For further information on the GPS settings, please refer to the InCommand Display User Guide available on the Ag Leader Knowledgebase. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.